everyone, welcome back to another video. This is Sarah. If you're new here, thanks for coming. I hope you are having a fabulous day, and if you're not, then hopefully this will distract you for a little bit. Today's video is a little shorter. I just did a really small build. This time I did a build based off of a 1940s post-war house. So in the United States after World War II in the 1940s, there was actually a housing shortage. So they tried to build as many houses as they could as quickly as possible. And obviously that tended to lead to much smaller houses. So that is what I base this off of. It's a very small house. And in fact, at that time, it wouldn't have been odd to have a house that was close to around 1,000 square feet, which is quite small, especially considering the fact that they did actually manage to get more than one bedroom in it. I did not manage that. I probably could have had I tried hard enough, but I was really wanting to make it aesthetically pleasing. I might be lying. I definitely could have tried harder and made it fit in there. And really, it's kind of difficult to judge the size of comparatively what 1,000 square feet would be in The Sims. I could technically like do the math to resize it, but it still just wouldn't be quite right. So I just kind of winged it and just made it what I thought looked small in The Sims. Here is actually a picture of what I based this build off of, and it looks like it actually came from like the page, some kind of magazine or catalog, because it included this information with it that had basically like a description and some actual layouts. I didn't really pay any attention to the layouts. I prefer to just do the layouts myself, but it was interesting to look at and kind of get an idea of what they were doing during that time period. So how are you guys doing? I know we're pretty far into quarantine now, so hopefully everyone still has their sanity intact. I know it's been tough for everyone. Actually, doing builds on The Sim has kind of helped me just have something to focus on and have something to keep me busy, so it's been cathartic, I would say. I really love that word, cathartic. You know, I don't really know why, but I have to say, if I had a favorite word in the English language, it would be cathartic. And I say that like I speak any other language. I mean, I do speak a little Japanese. I've studied Japanese for many, many years, and I do intend to go there. So what is my favorite Japanese word? I actually think there would probably be two. One of them being hisashiburi, which means basically long time no see. I really like that. I don't know why. It just feels good to say. And then natsukashi, which is basically like nostalgic. It just feels good. It rolls off the tongue, you know? It just, So I live in the United States, if you can't tell from my y'all that I come up with sometimes. It's been tough lately. The US has been struggling. I mean, it's been struggling this whole pandemic, but you know, it's struggling again now, really quite badly. So let's just focus on this build. The one thing that isn't going wrong, until it does go wrong. Because I do something stupid, like what I'm about to do right now. Like not fully put the stove flush with the corner. Don't worry, I will fix that. Because yes, it bothers me too. So recently my mom and I have started watching Scooby-Doo, like the old Scooby-Doos. And recently we started watching the original one from 1969, I believe. And oh my god, it brings back so many memories, which sounds so weird because I am not that old. But apparently, when I looked it up, they did reruns of that for many years on kids' channels over, you know, the 90s and the 2000s. So that would explain why I have such a vivid memory of some of these episodes that are like 50 years old. Ugh, watching them is just so nostalgic. I remember watching Scooby-Doo growing up and like the movies. And actually just a few years ago, and I was like 20 at the time. My mom and I watched the Mystery Incorporated series on Netflix, which I definitely recommend. And oh, that was so good. I do have to admit, and I'm sure if you have ever watched movies or kids shows from that time, then you know that shows during the 1900s, the late 1900s, aren't exactly like plot-wise very complex. There really isn't an overarching plot in the Scooby-Doo, Where Are You? But in the Mystery Incorporated, there is. And I think that really made it, or that is what made it such a great series. And I don't know if they did that on purpose because they were trying to, appeal to an older audience maybe that grew up watching Scooby-Doo, but also try to get kids at the same time. I don't know. I mean, I feel like it worked really well and I really enjoyed it. So yeah, I guess this video is just a deep dive into Scooby-Doo now. Sorry about that. So then, getting back to the build, I actually did go to a website to kind of get an idea of what kind of interior design you would have seen. I have to be honest with you, I hate all of this. I hate it all. But I promise you, if you look up 1940s interior design, you will see this whack shit everywhere. Like the horribly like mismatched rooms, the horrible floral wallpaper. I mean, I saw some pictures. I'm gonna try to find them and put them up here. They looked like someone went into a store blindfolded, spun around about 50 times, and then just randomly picked whatever they happened upon and threw it into a room. It just looks, I mean, I don't get the appeal. I don't get it. To each their own. I respect you. You have my utmost respect, but not a fan. Not my style, that is for sure. So I did finally get my gaming laptop back. It took about a month for the repairs, but I do have it back now. Like I said, I got it and it had some issues with the keyboard, so I sent it in right away. Didn't even wait a day. I like sent it in the next day. So it is back. It seems to be working great now. I will start working on videos on that now from here on out, and hopefully I'll be doing a Twitch stream soon doing a build. So I'm looking forward to that. And hopefully it'll be easier for me now to actually make videos where my face is actually in it because I have that webcam, so you'll actually be able to see my face soon, hopefully. Hopefully it'll be easier because it has been kind of an editing nightmare for the past month. Let me just say that. And now I am recording with a dog on my lap. Oh my God. Yes, hello, Dexter. Oh goodness. Oh no. Yeah, we have a lot of pets at my house. Welcome to the zoo. So I decided to try to do a full pink bathroom since that was a thing in the 1940s, and over many years there's been a theme of having just fully pink bathrooms. So I gave it a shot. I think it turned out good. I don't know. It's pink. Everything in it is pink. You can't really almost tell, like the toilet and the tub almost don't look pink. And I had a hard time finding a towel. Like the pink towel was just like too pink. Like the pinks in The Sims don't really match very well. But I did my best. So I did end up going through and deciding to add curtains to things. I just feel like it makes it look polished. Even though really, like I normally in the past would never have used curtains in my builds because I didn't really think about it honestly. But now that I'm like a professional, like a Sims YouTuber. No, I'm kidding. But yeah, now I kind of feel like I have to do it in order to make it look finished and complete and like put together. Although there are definitely some builds that you really don't need curtains, like if it's modern and it's supposed to be very open. But in this build, I definitely felt like it needed curtains, so I shot some in there. I did decide to go with a blue theme for the bedroom. I just feel like blue is very great for bedrooms, personally, like even in real life, just because it's such a calming color. The kitchen is fun. It's a nice, bright, alarmingly red red. But I don't know, I think it works. I think even though it kind of looks like somebody just randomly picked colors and threw it in there, I still think it ended up turning out pretty good. As I'm sure you've noticed throughout the video, I had a really hard time picking out what I wanted to do with the roof, which is sad considering it's like literally the most simple roof possible. But I was just like, I could not get the color right. And if you notice in the picture earlier, the roof is actually green in that picture. And it just does not work in The Sims. They just do not have the right color roof for that. So it just did not work. So I ended up just going with like a slate color. And I decided to kind of do like a little garden area surrounded by those rocks. We have that in our backyard, and I've seen that a lot of places. I really like that outlining with the rocks, with the plants behind it. I feel like it looks really crisp and put together. So that is what I ended up doing in the backyard with a little bench and then a little grill, and then finally a little gate. All right, now I can take you into the build so you can get a first-person perspective.
I 100% almost said purse-person.
All right, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope to see you in the next video. Please like and subscribe. Hit that bell icon if you want to be notified anytime I upload. And I will see you next time. Bye.